So, the facility, we're getting a new roof put on. So they have a lot of equipment out. And the popcorn is here. But the truck can't get to the back of the facility. And this is the popcorn seed that I will be planting. So I'm gonna drive out and load it up into the bed of the pickup and then take it back to the back of the facility myself. It's double the work, but I don't care. This guy's pretty nice. So just make things work.
So the driver pulled up parallel to the curb out front of the facility, and I stuck my GoPro in this little redbud tree. It's nice and pink in the spring. It's native to eastern Kansas. But so at any rate, I backed up my truck, back, and I ended up hitting the truck because he didn't know I had a hitch on the back. But that's okay. So we decided to just rip off the shrink wrap on the pallet, and then I hopped up there after getting the packing list from him and started unloading 50 pounds at a time, just bag after bag. So we kind of got into a rhythm here where he would hand them to me, and it was really easy work. And as you can see, this, I've sped it up, but it went pretty quick. And he was telling me stories about growing up in Arkansas, and as a youth, he had a job tossing 50-pound bags of rice into train cars, which were destined for China. And he thought that was pretty funny that we sold rice to China. But we got done, and it was a little bit of a workout, but fun to do. There they are, loaded up in the bed of the pickup truck, which I just drove around to the front of the facility, the back of the facility, and then started loading onto the same pallet that they came off of. 31 bags on, 31 bags off, no big deal. You might see those IBC totes in the upper right-hand corner of the image. I'm cleaning those out right now, and they will be the water supply for my drip irrigation for the sweet potato plants that we're planting. I have 1,000 sweet potatoes, the Beauregard variety, going in about May 1st, and we'll lay down some drip tape and plastic mulch, and then those will, I have a small 12-volt electric pump that will pump water through the drip tape. But at any rate, I'm almost done loading up the corn here onto the pallet, and very happy to have it done.
Exciting time, just got the seed corn delivered. This is what we'll plant in the ground to grow our popcorn. Got it off a outfit out of Nebraska called Zanger's. Family-owned business, they've been doing it since the 20s. Got it delivered to the facility, got some of our equipment, just a little bit of our equipment, moved here so far, but a few stats here. So 1,550 pounds on 31 bags. I didn't stack it very neat because I had to take it off of a 53-foot tractor trailer. Don't have a forklift, so had to do it by hand, which is no big deal. It's a good workout. So 130,000 seeds per bag, 31 bags. That's 4,030,000 seeds. So just think about that, 4 million corn plants out there growing popcorn. And that should yield about 750,000 pounds of popcorn. Pretty cool. Oh, and incidentally, for the same price that I paid for this pallet of popcorn, you could buy a small vehicle. It's, seed corn is pretty expensive, but it's a hybrid, so they've put a lot of breeding effort into it, crossing one strain with another, seeing the results, and you know, they don't always succeed. So it takes a lot of time and effort. So it's really worth the price. It's just costs a lot of money.
Keep up with the developments of the brand by subscribing to our YouTube channel and liking us on Facebook.